Thank you. we're gonna have to get creative with this. Should be interesting. Thank you. Well, it's getting way too dark to see out here, but I have to know if this is going to work. Pretty sure it's going to work, but I got to see it on the mill. It's going to make me crazy until I do. Oh, that worked out well. You know, a couple of clamps, a little planning would have made this right. Come on. There we go. Let's see what happens. I don't even have to go that far. One more. Nice. put it off any longer. Time to try to flip this thing over. But I think first what I'm going to do is just make sure that these timbers are going to handle it. I'm kind of taking a chance here. But what's the worst that's going to happen? I got to fix a floor. I get crushed under some beams. I guess that would be a really shitty thing, huh? Off. Everything in my shop is loud and cluttered and loud. What we have to raise this up is I have these 1-ton chain hoists suspended from the timbers upstairs. So basically what we do is we have a 6x6 spanning 3 of the 5x8 floor joists, but we put them fairly close to the 10x16 tie beams. So what we're going to do is we're going to loop our chain file around these big pipe nipples I have welded on. And we're going to try to use it like a big rotisserie. And what we're also going to do in this process is try to scoot this thing back far enough from the door so that I can get a tongue on this thing inside the building. So we're going to try to step off to the side for sure and see what develops here. This is either going to go swimmingly well or really crappy. I don't think there's going to be much for any cleaning. Six jacks off the floor. Now chain falls, chain hoists, whatever you want to call them, they're slow. But I'm going to tell you an old saying that's so true, that slow is smooth and smooth is fast. When you're using hand-operated chain falls, it's a lot harder to make a mistake in what you're doing because you're cranking every inch of the way. It's a slow pickup, it's a slow movement, but that also makes it, in my world, a hell of a lot safer to do stupid stuff like this. Now we have a piece of metal, scrap metal, welded on the end of this thing, and that's just so the strap can't slide off. We have that on both ends. Now this is going to want to swing just a little bit. Time here. So remember, like I said, we're moving this whole frame backwards. And when we do it just a couple inches at a time like this, it's going to control how much this thing can swing back towards me, because this is a lot of weight. If I had that other end picked way up and I just started cranking on this, this thing would come in here and take me out right at the legs, and that would really suck. Just very easily letting the weight of this thing do the work for me. In fact, right now I could probably, right there. So we're going to let this end down. This is going to be the fun part. This is the adventurous part. think I need a bigger barn. A little bit more. Here goes. Freaking awesome. Thank you. You're good. Thank you. What?
Also, I and once somebody lost me in the camper when it just messed up.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. And then I was alone. Because no one was in there and I did and nobody had a key.
Oh yeah?
Except mommy.
Yeah? Oh no!
Well, actually, mommy kept it there. You know why?
Right.
Well, you know why?
Why?
So I don't forget it. And I'm busy. But Grant, his mom just let him take it home.
Oh yeah?
My mom wasn't took it home, Grant did, but except me.
Oh yeah?
And Sammy did too, but except me.
No way.
Mom said let me.
Oh yeah?
But maybe she should try.
What are you writing a book?
No.
You sure?
Mommy and
I. You work for the government?
No. Mommy and I were watching a movie. I know.
What are you doing? Don't you touch the camera. You little crackhead.
I'm not now. What does it look like I'm doing?
Do you want the camera for a minute? Do you want to just stand and talk to the camera? Okay, hold on. That'll get you over. Alright guys, let's show you the plan for mounting the axles. Now like I said, the main issue I had here was that the axles are a little bit slightly wider than the actual trailer frame I built, and that's piss poor planning on my part because I could have made the frame wide enough to accept it. So anyway, 1/2 inch plate steel, 6 inch channel, another piece of 1/2 inch plate steel. We're gonna do triple welds here. I've already have 2 on here. I want a big wide weld there, enough to support any of the, it's pretty much, this is going to be one of the main structural welds on this frame, because this is one that's going to be carrying us down the road. So this one's super important. Very, very important. I do understand that it is hard to see in here because everything kind of blends together. So our next important step, I said how important that was structurally, how that is. Honestly, I built that thing like a tank. I honestly don't think it's going to be a big issue. But the other thing we have to take into consideration here is how we're going to make these axles square to the trailer so everything goes down the road perfectly. It's not so much, they don't need to be square to the neap of the trailer, which would be the bed, but they do need to be measured properly off of the hitch up front. So what I have is I have a mark up here, a little grind line, where I can hook the tape measure and measure down to the center point on this axle bracket, whatever the hell you want to call it. I've got to make sure that measurement matches exactly on the other side. And if I do that, this thing will come together square and it'll pull down the road properly. It won't look like it's dog-legged off to the side. It won't be wearing my tires out. That's important, you know, just like the alignment on your vehicle. Again, I'm not speaking from experience. I'm speaking from reading, but I have seen plenty of trailers over the years going down the road kicked off to one side, and they're usually the homemade ones. So we're going to try to avoid that. I want you to hold the tape measure. See this mark right here?
Yep.
You hold the 10-inch mark right there, okay?
Yep.
Very important. Hold it nice and tight.
Yep.
Okay, let it twist.
Yep.
Put it. See what I'm doing? Quiet. Flatten your tape out. You gotta let it turn with me.
All
right. Let go of your thumb. There you go. Is that 10-inch mark right on there?
Okay.
Hold on, just 1 second. Wyatt, can you hold it the same spot you held it the last time?
Yep.
Were you on the top or the bottom of the tape?
I was, yep.
Okay. You tell me when you're good.
I'm good.
1 second. Sorry, just squaring up where the axles are pulling this thing. You still good there, Wyatt?
Yep. Yep.
Oh, that's a good eyeball. Huh, you're in the money, Ma. Thank you. tell you what, I can't wait to pull this out of here, sweep the damn floor. What's that, bud?
No, I just got a question. Keep it balanced, okay?
Yep.
Come too far, Dad.
Yeah, I know, right? Okay. Thank you. So this is the kind of shit you almost hate doing, because this is the kind of stuff where guys get killed in crazy, crazy manners. And I tell you, since that last accident there, you're always thinking of that. It's always in the back of your mind. You're always staring things over and you're looking at every little possible scenario. And you're thinking to yourself, all it takes is one little load shift and I'm done. It's over. I mean, this thing's heavy enough to crush me, you know, if any of my kids were out here. So for those of you who don't think that I take that kind of thing seriously, that I'm a little too cavalier with my safety, well, believe me, I am always, 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 always thinking about it these days. I'm always planning everything out in the back of my mind to nauseam, sitting here just staring at something for hours until it's like, okay, I have a good plan. This was one of them. Now, the idea behind this chain hoist near the middle, for one, was to hold this thing while I was switching the strap, because we have the tongue on there now, and there's no way with that tongue on there I would be able to do what I need to do and flip that strap without causing some damage to something or getting hurt, because there's no way you're going to hold this thing up with one hand while you're switching that strap. But the other thing with this on here, I can use this to control the descent of this thing spinning around to the other side. That's the big part. That's the big deal for me. Because what I can do, as I raise this other side, this thing's going to want to naturally start tipping that way. And as it does that, the chain could start, I could just start letting it out slowly. Once I get this other tire here off the ground, because right now that's what's holding it from spinning, this thing should start to come the other way. So let's see what happens. Something like this, constantly look for anything shifting. What got me hurt the last time was I was not looking for that gin pole shifting, and that's what happened. It shifted just enough when I had my hands on it that it slid and it tripped me. That's where it gets shifting loads are super dangerous. Oh, I could pull this out and sweep my floor. Then I could pull it back in and finish welding. Okay, hold on. Set her down a second. Just hold on. Wait. I said, wait.
Want it down that way?
Not too much right yet. Okay.
Are you all right?
Yeah. And lift it over that jack. It's all right. I'm gonna. Yeah, we can.
Good?
Yeah, hold on, we'll wheel it.
What's that?
We can wheel it.
Yeah.
Hold on. You're under there as far as you can, as straight as you can. Whoa. Okay, you're close. Don't say that yet, we're not on it yet. Okay, you're good right now. Easy. Hold on. Wait. Okay, a little more. Wait. Go ahead and bring her up a little. A little more. A little more. A little more. The more, good, good. That's good. Whoa, little. Okay, step on off the wheeler.
Might want to hold on to that gap. So we go put another clamp up there so that doesn't roll off.
Yep. Just want to get this weight as low as we can. Coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. A little more. All right, my turn. Thank you.
repair?
Why is it nothing with you always sounds like something?
Well, I was doing something.
What were you doing?
Watch the video.
Bedtime.
Oh. Yeah, but
I think the bigger logs work better, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, just hold on a minute. I thought it was.
Ready?